Hello everybody, I'm the Captain here and welcome to a let's play of Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, The Sith Lords. So this game holds near and dear to my heart. I know this is probably the last thing that anybody would say for this game in particular, but this is what introduced me to the Old Republic, and this is what got me into the Old Republic, the MMO. It got me into, well, pretty much the whole entire sub story of 3,000 years before the movies happen. So I'm a huge Star Wars fan, so I like to know that, I like to think that I know quite a bit about the whole Star Wars universe, but well, let's see how that tests out. So, but anyways, let's get started here. This game is, I got it off Steam, and I'm not putting in any of the, I didn't put in any of the restoration patches. This is the pure game as it is. Long story short, I mean, this was the game that I played when I was younger on an old busted ass computer that kept restarting itself, so it was kind of a pain to play through that, but I managed to play through that and I managed to complete it actually. So in any case, let's pick our character here. So I'm gonna be playing a little bit canon to the actual story, so, but I'm not gonna name her Mithra Suric. So, okay, let me just pick my who do I pick? Guardian, Sentinel, Consular. Most people say that, actually not most people, most guides used to say that that the best class is actually you play as a Consular, then you turn into a Weapon Master at the end. But, you know what, I'm just gonna go with a Guardian first, and then I'll go into Jedi Master. Because why not? So now, custom character. Let's fully customize this. Okay, so the Jedi Exile. Yep, I'm just cycling through the faces because the face I want to pick is this one. Now, this was the face that I went with back then. It's still the face that I'm gonna go now because I like this face over the rest of them. So it's kind of yeah, it's really my personal choice because this is what I like to imagine. I don't know why I'm rambling about, so let's just get into attributes now. Okay, so she's a guardian. I'll just make this base 12 first, because I got a lot of points here. And 6 points left, so it should go into wisdom. Since I gotta be a master, so I should have a lot of wisdom, and I am going to be, well, since I'm a guardian, so I'm just gonna be a strength person, maybe up to 14. You can't go past it, so because you need 2 points. That'll be interesting to note, and I guess the other 2 points, it goes into constitution. I wanted to put into charisma, but nah. We'll see how this goes. And the music is being epic as I remember it to be. Okay, so here's the thing. I like to play somebody who can do almost anything. So kind of like a one-person role. So I know I have teammates. I know that I can use them to help me cover my losses. So, but yeah, I'm not gonna do that. Let me just put point in awareness so that I can look at mines. Let's put a point in that first. Demolition, because there's gonna be a lot of decoding to do, and I like to do that by myself. So max points is at 4, so I'll just keep this at 3. 3. Yeah. Awareness, I'll put it at 2. Treat injury, I'll put it at 2. And persuade at 1. Because dialogue options. Alright, so now for feats. I've been granted all of these, which is neat. Force jump. I haven't read force jump. Oh, okay. If diplomacy fails, combat must be swift beside you. When an opponent at range is targeted with a standard lightsaber. Okay, so basically this is basically the force leap. Okay, I didn't know that. This bonus is retroactive to levels previously gained. Oh, okay. So I don't have to get this now. Which is neat. So I am going to be a I'm gonna be a duelist, so I'm just gonna be a single blader. Single bladed lightsaber player. Yep, single player. At feet. Okay, and I'll put more into weapon focus and lightsaber mastery. Weapon specialization when I get those points. But at the same time, I probably will want to get conditioning and that toughness that I pointed out. And dual strike. Okay, that'll be interesting. That'll be something you keep with you. Stealth run. I'm not particularly good with stealth. Unless it's in the Old Republic, so because they made stuff so much easier and so much they put it into the combat, so that's why it's much more easier. But anyways, that's all. Okay, the name I'm gonna pick, it's not Mara Rosan and it's not Mithra Suric because I don't really like that name so much. Apologies for those that do, but Mithra Suric really doesn't roll for me. What rolls for me, thank you, Epic Music. What rolls for me is the name of Kira Salar. Yeah, this was a randomly generated name back in the day, and I like this name. I'm sticking to this name. Let's go. Okay. Okay, so the movie is glitched out on me, so instead of getting the opening text, I've got the Obsidian Entertainment thing, so hello, T3.
The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much needed repairs. Your fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
Okay, so I'm not gonna bore you with the prologue. Basically, T3 manages to fix the ship and get you a health pack so that you can make it to the Paragus mining facility so that you can get some proper medical attention. So I will not bore you with the tutorials. I'll just skip the prologue and head straight into the story. Apologies if you guys can't see the cutscene, so my recorder doesn't do that, which is sad. So probably might see a blank, you know, probably might see a black screen, but I'll figure something out. Okay, save often and in different slots. Good tip. Okay, so how the hell does she get out the coastal tank? Fun note, I remember when this game came out, it wasn't patched at all. And so when you were lying in the medical bed, your eyes are actually opened. If any of you remember those, you know what I'm talking about. So you remember how freaky that was a bit, so. Journal entry added, so. I love this pose. There's a lot of sass in the female pose. So, anyways, to the journal. Recent history: you've awakened in a medical bay in an unknown facility. The last thing you remember is being a passenger on a Republic Capital ship, the Harbinger. You should find out where you are and how you got here. Pardon if I blumber up some of the words. So, immersions in coastal tanks can heal most wounds. If you've lost vitality points during your expedition, yep. So I can just go back to the coastal tank if I need a free heal. So, okay. Morgue door. Locked. Damage door. Any door that can be bashed open can be cut through more easily with a lightsaber or construction tool.
Emergency lockdown is in effect.
Okay, yeah. I need a plasma torch for that. Go to this door. Medical bay container. Two med packs. That would be helpful. Hello, lab station. Hi. I remember using this a lot, so I have no chemicals, so I can't make stuff. But yeah, you can use, just to explain for those that haven't played this yet. I don't imagine why. The lab station allows you to create some of the stuff that you need, like med packs, implants, stimulants. You can even make mines as well. That's why I picked up demolition, because I can just convert them into chemicals and I can make them into more useful stuff like med packs and maybe grenades, because grenades are good. So at least this early on before I have my lightsaber and stuff. So anyways, medical computer. There's gonna be a lot of dialogue in this game, so you know. Here we go. Log 25312.
Still examining the survivors of the damaged freighter. Looks like it goes by the name of the Ebon Hawk. Only one survivor, placed in the coastal tank for recovery. The carbon scoring on the vessel suggests it was in a battle, but no indication of who fired on it. Couldn't get much from the Nava computer. I'm surprised the ship was able to make it inside the Paragus asteroid field without the asteroid drift charts. Aside from the lone survivor, we recovered an old woman. No life signs. There was also a protocol droid and a utility droid on board. Sent both down to maintenance while security sorts through the other items on the ship. It looks like the utility droid, a T3 unit, was able to get the ship working enough to get to the colony. We're prepared to.
Why does holo recordings keep ending in static? I don't get it. And the whole cutoff thing is so done on purpose, just to not give you the full story behind it. But I guess that's kind of the draw of it with a story. They don't give you the whole thing; they just give you hints and pieces, and you gotta piece them together. Anyway, 25315.
Could be a Jedi, but we won't know for sure until we get the transmission back from the Republic. If the survivor is a Jedi, that would account for the recovery rate. But I'm more concerned that a Jedi here may cause trouble. Some of the miners, especially Korta, are already st another accident today. A detonation in the ventilation tunnels. If the lockdown measures hadn't activated, the whole facility would have been destroyed. Got most of the injured to the Colto tanks in time, but the rest had to go to the morgue. One of the wounded said a droid caused the accident, but we couldn't get any specifics.
Okay, so I should be commenting on the story, but I haven't been paying much attention to it. But I kind of knew what the whole overarching story is, so I'll pay attention this time around. Sorry. 253 AT.
Miners about the Jedi. A number of the droids have been acting oddly, and not even memory wipes seem to be fixing the problem. There was a detonation in another one of the fuel vents the droids were working in. We deactivated several of them and moved them down to maintenance, but we're still treating the plasma burns. That cuts us down to almost half shifts, and with the droids malfunctioning, we may not make the Telos shipment for this month. Fortunately, the detonation didn't cause a lockdown.
Warning! There has been a fuel detonation in the mining tunnels. Emergency lockdown commencing. All personnel report to quarters and prepare for emergency venting countermeasures.
No! If the ventilation systems are malfunctioning, evacuate the medical bay! Everyone evacuate!
Ooh, something bad was going on. Something is happening here in this facility. So, let's check the patient life signs. Deceased, recovered, deceased, and deceased. Okay. Okay, so I was in Culture Tank 3, so I recovered, of course, because I'm a Jedi. Yeah. Okay, patient treatments. All subjects being treated for severe plasma burns. Last treatment request resulted in death of all subjects except patient 3, who was reduced to minimal life signs. Treat injury. A lethal dose of sedatives was administered to all tanks, including number 3. There's no record of who ordered the treatment. So, I don't have a computer spike, so I cannot do this. So, okay. Medical bay functions. I access the medical bay camera. That camera is pointed to my coldo tank. Locked on the coldo tank, you emerge from. Okay. More camera. Oh, okay. There's only 2 bodies here. Okay. Unlock door to morgue. Okay. That gives me a place to go. Unlock medical storage room, which is the room right behind me. Yay! More free stuff. Access the medical inventory. Number of medical base items can be malfunctioned. Basically, I just explain what the lab station does. So, console. I think that's all of them. So let's log out. And I shall loot these boxes. Ooh, 5 chemicals. Okay, and more map packs. Let's head into the morgue. And what's this aggression doing here? Corpse. This old woman looks dead, but there's no sign of what killed her. Yeah, right. This corpse has a plasma torch. Just what I need to get through the other door. Forgive me, I have a nostalgia boner right now.
Find what you're looking for amongst the dead.
I thought you were dead. Your voice, I heard it. Cold tank, who are you? Let's go with I thought you were dead.
Close to death. Yes, closer than I'd like. You have the smell of the Colto tank about you. How do you feel?
A little disoriented. Okay, so a little disoriented. Was it your voice I heard in the Colto tank?
Yes, I had hoped as much. I slept here too long and could not awaken. It may be I reached out unconsciously, and your mind must have been a willing one. Or perhaps you have been trained for such things.
So you can touch minds and feign death. Who are you? Yeah, I'm gonna pick that option.
I am Kreia, and I am your rescuer, as you are mine. Tell me, do you recall what happened?
Okay. Last thing I remember, I was on board a Republic ship, the Harbinger. What happened to it?
Your ship was attacked. You were the only survivor. A result of your Jedi training, no doubt.
Jedi training? If you think I'm a Jedi, you're mistaken. I'm no longer a member of the Order. How do you know I was Jedi?
Your stance, your walk, tells me you are a Jedi. Your walk is heavy. You carry something that weighs you down.
Okay. That is no business of yours.
So it would seem. Keep your past and let us focus on the now.
Alright. Okay. Yeah, basically I'm answering my own voice here, so. Alright, what's going on here? How did we get here?
I do not know. I was removed from the events of the world as I slept. A survey of the surroundings may provide the answers we seek. The ship we arrived in must still be in this place. We should recover it and leave.
Okay, why do we need to leave? Care to explain why you're in such a hurry? Why do we need to leave?
We were attacked once, and I fear our attackers will not give up the hunt so easily. Without transport, weapons, and information, they will find us easy prey indeed.
Okay. This is my awareness. Awareness, you seem nervous, worried. Something wrong?
Even as I slept, I felt much unrest here. I saw strange visions, minds colored with fear. Now, everything here feels terribly silent. I would find out as much as you can about this place quickly. I fear we will need to depart as suddenly as we arrived.
Okay. We'll see. That's okay. We'll see. There's got to be someone left alive around here.
You may wish to extend your search to some clothes, if only for proper first impressions.
It's funny because these are considered the undergarments in the Star Wars universe. I kind of like these, but I don't see why this is kind of like you walking around in your underwear. So, but anyways, persuade. The patients in Med Bay were killed by lethal dose of sedatives. Any idea how it happened? I'm just gonna try and persuade.
I do not know. Why did they spare you?
They didn't. I got the same dose but survived.
Indeed, a Jedi trance could protect one from such poisons. In fact, the sedatives may have been intended to keep you unconscious for some time. It would prove lethal to those untrained in such techniques, however. Most curious.
You seem to know a lot about Jedi techniques.
And so do you. Perhaps we could discuss it at length later on. Now we have other concerns, among them finding our new enemy.
Okay, maybe I'll return with action. Okay. I'll return soon just to make sure you're alright.
I leave you to the explorations of this place. Here I will remain and attempt to center myself.
Okay, and we got our first light side points. Yeah, okay. So you need to find a ship, Admiral Hawk. Elder woman named Kreia informed you that she rescued you from the Harbinger, only survived with the vessel and had been attacked. Okay, I know how you got here. Medical Bay murders. You found records showing a lethal sedative that was given to the miners in the Paragus Medical Bay. We see you saved lethal dose but survived. You try find out who administered the treatment and why they tried to kill you. Okay, so this is the stuff that I got. This thing's gonna be glowing, so I have to ignore that. So let me just quickly equip. Thank you. Let me just quickly equip the plasma torch here. Okay, so that's gonna do it for this part of the playthrough. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and do subscribe to me as well. You can follow me on Twitter at IamZaCaptain. ZA Captain, so you guys would know. All the stuff will be in the descriptions below. So anyways, thank you guys for watching and I'll see you next video. Bye.